Hallo. The birds. Yesterday it looked like this everywhere. Even this morning. See the dark clouds in the background? Yesterday, then this morning, for a moment I thought it was going to rain. Because the sun was like, it was almost like a rainy season. Almost like August. Well, not August, about mid-September. But slowly, clear it up. Ocean. Sunset. Get that ocean. And beautiful sunset. But, oh. And all this beauty. Like he's saying, all this beauty everywhere around. But it seems like we can't keep our landscape beautiful. Somewhere the people who call themselves gardeners always trying to create issues, you know? The French were in Niger and Burkina Faso, Sahel, them and their people they were training to carry out the terrorist actions all over West Africa and East Africa too. And then one by one the African people said, you know what, we don't want this in our country. Too many of us are dying and these French people are not doing anything. creating havoc, devastation in our country. So they kicked the French out. Ethiopia kicked the Tigray. With the help of their brothers in the Horn of Africa. Kicked out the US trained Tigray. Terrorist out. Not to be undaunted as they were trying to start up the war between Rwanda and the Congo now. And since Rwanda is not going for it, now they have President Ghana stirring up trouble with Burkina Faso. They're still fighting a war, the proxy war in Ukraine. But instead of waiting the 3 years before they pivot to Africa, they're trying to get one going now, and they're trying to get the Africans against Africans. It's not the US and the EU, NATO going in like they did in Iraq and Afghanistan and Syria and Horn of Africa, or getting the Southeast or going to Yemen. They're trying to get the Africans to fight against each other. Then when Ghana decided that they want to fight against Burkina Faso, and by chance they lose a few people, they call to America for help, and then America sends in what? Well, the American army is already in Ghana, so. I remember Madeleine Albright's comment when she asked, when she was talking to Swarkoff, you know, got this beautiful army, what can they do? What can you do with it? And they found a war to do it. Not only one war, but two. And after that, it was like, oh, you got a project for another 100 years. Wars all over the planet. But the probably funny thing why I mentioned this is because African leaders, I mean, $55 million in reparations for the slave trade given to Africa. Are these African leaders? But the African leaders never asked, what about reparations for our brothers in Brazil and the US? President Ghana went talk to black Americans in America. Yeah, we need you to come up and help us build. But then when he wanted to borrow some money from the IMF, he disparaged his brothers in Burkina Faso to get the loan. That's going in debt every Ghanaian for the next 3 years. And then they have to reapply for the loan to cut, to pay back that loan. It's gonna double the loan amount from 3 to 6 billion in 3 years. We cannot continue to fight each other like this. At one point, we're gonna have to stop this foolishness. At some point, otherwise, Africa, it's gonna be looking like Syria and Afghanistan. Iraq, Vietnam, Grenada, little island, 100 square miles, less than 100 square miles. Some of these African leaders are looking at the sunset every day and the sunrise, seeing how beautiful their jungle is. Because Mr. Borrell is back at it again with his disparaging Africans. Do Africans really, do they even know where Ukraine is? Yes, we know where Ukraine is. We know more about Ukraine than you know about Africa. African leaders better start listening to what these people are saying. I mean, they're just barely surviving in the cold. Just barely surviving. And they still have the audacity to insult and depreciate your country, our countries. One may not be strong enough to fight against them, but you gotta join together. If you're not strong enough, it's like a family. When somebody enter your compound to fight with you, you call your family. Say, hey, I got this idiot in the compound. I need some help throwing him out. That's what you have to do. So, anyway. Yep, beautiful sun. Beautiful sky. Somebody's burning their trash. Children. Kids playing. People building. That's everywhere in Africa. Many houses going up, businesses going up, infrastructure around that's needed to accommodate all this other activity is not going up. Not coming. Those clouds are just beautiful. just hanging there in the air. So beautiful. Mango tree. Thought the mango tree had blossoms on it. Oh, I missed mangoes though. It's the mangoes. I love mangoes. And avocados. Miss the mangoes and avocados. Yeah, the moon is gone already. Love this view, trees as far as the eye can see. Trees and the clouds. And the sunshine. So beautiful. Seeing this every day instead of a concrete jungle is breathtaking, you know? Alright, wish I can't make the video too much longer. 20 minutes, I like to. Don't want to bore you. Wherever you are, make sure you stay safe. Enjoy your day. Take 10 minutes out of your day to see the sunrise and sunset. If you have kids, teach them how to enjoy the world around them. Because they are the builders of tomorrow. And then paving over everything as you see in the West, you know, in London and New York, is not the way to go. Alright. Have a great day wherever you are. Stay strong. Just like the sun setting here right now. Some people are seeing the sunset and scared. Some people are seeing the sunset and saying, hey, you know, the sun is going to rise tomorrow. And that's me. My sun is rising. Have a great evening or day, wherever you are. Peace.